Tonight I'll be drinking a Pepsi in honor of that one time that I reacted to cola while drinking a Pepsi and didn't realize at all what I was doing until after I uploaded the video. My pussy tastes like Pepsi Cola. What is up? How you guys doing? I hope you're doing well. And yes, I know I've been getting yelled at by every Lana Del Rey fan ever for not posting this sooner. You can still kind of hear I had a cold, and my voice has been absolute shit for a while, and it's very annoying. I've been so excited to listen to this album just because you guys are saying it's really good and that you really like it. For the past like 2 weeks since I've been sick and haven't been able to listen to this, I've been listening to mostly Norman Rockwell, and I just like cannot believe how perfect that album is. No album of hers I think will ever beat that one, just because that is pure perfection from start to finish. But Blue Bannisters, I literally didn't even know it was coming out, because I know she had said an album was coming out, but there have been so many times where she said there's an album coming out and then there's actually no album coming out. Rock Candy Sweet. So I was like really unsure, and then suddenly it was out, and I was like, I'm sick and I couldn't listen to it, but we're here. We're here now. Here we have the track list for Blue Bannisters. I believe Textbook Through Arcadia was out before the album, but I haven't heard any of these songs yet, so I'm really excited about that. We will be watching videos for Blue Bannisters and Arcadia, and the song I'm most excited about based on track title is If You Lie Down With Me.
I guess you could call it Textbook. I was looking for the father I wanted back.
Is the song gonna build?
It seemed only appropriate you'd easily have my back. You got a thunderbird.
There it is.
My daddy had one too. Let's rewrite his story. I'll do this dance with you. There we were, screaming Black Lives Matter in the crowd.
Interesting.
People say we're too much alike, but maybe finally that'll make it right at the end. Old Man River keeps rolling.
Ooh, wait, that sounds cool.
Him.
Sounds like a rain stick or something. Wow. Okay. All right. So I'm feeling a couple different things right now. One, first and foremost, that outro is gorgeous because it sounds like there's like use of like a rain stick or something. It sounds like water, like Old Man River keeps rolling, and it just, the instrumental really reflects the lyrics, which I love. This one, it didn't grab me on the first listen, but with Lana, I feel like her music's, it always grows on me more the more I listen to it. Her lyrics are so complex, always. They always go over my head, and it takes me time to really get to know her song. It's a pretty song. It's not like my favorite Lana song as of right now, but I think it could grow on me. So the next track that we're going to listen to is Blue Bannisters. It is the title track.
There's a picture on the wall of me on a John Deere. Jenny handed me a beer, said, how the hell did you get there?
Oh, that is gorgeous. Hi, Lana.
Jenny jumped into the pool. She was swimming with Nikki Lane. She said, most men want a woman with a legacy in her veins. She said,
I have to pause for a second. This is gorgeous. I'm loving the storytelling, first of all, like the very like specific, Jenny did this, she asked me this about this specific thing, where it was from, and this is what I said. I love that kind of like storytelling. This is gorgeous. And the video is just like really simple so far, but really pretty. Oh my gosh. Her voice on this is unreal.
All my sisters come to paint my banisters green.
Ooh.
My blue banisters gray. Blue banisters are green and gray.
Wow. I just like, I have chills right now.
Summer comes,
take a quick look at the lyrics because I feel like I know what this song is about, but I'm not sure, and it's beautiful. There was one part where she references like us three, and there were three in the video. I don't know if specifically, like I don't know if those were just actresses or if those were real friends of hers, but it seems like the song is about like a guy who she like loves or whatever, who says he'll always be there and then he's not, and then they kind of take his place. She says Jenny and Chucky, I think, are the two people that she references in the song. That was so beautiful. Okay, I was a little nervous because that first track, well, it was okay, it like wasn't my favorite. That was perfection. The lyrics, I actually kind of understood a little bit better, and the sound and everything. Oh my god, yes. Okay, I think I'm gonna go swap out my Pepsi for a tea because my throat's starting to hurt again. But then we are going to listen to / watch the video for Arcadia.
My body is a map of LA. I stand straight like an angel. My hips, every high and by way that you trace with your fingertips like a Toyota. Run down the blood that flows straight to
oh my god, the lyrics!
Heart.
The lyrics! Oh!
Arcadia.
Why? How? I don't. Okay.
My curve, San Gabriel all day. My lips. Like the phylix of bay. They built me up 300 feet tall just to tear me down. So I'm leaving with nothing but laughter in this town, America.
What? Oh. Where is this going? Hello? What? Wait, okay, that's definitely not in the actual song. Oh my god. Okay, lyrically, holy crap. I love a good metaphor, and this entire song is her using her body as a metaphor for like Los Angeles, and the way she says like you can run your hands over me, like a Land Rover, a Toyota, all the roads that lead to you, as integral to me as arteries that pump the blood that flows straight to the heart of me. I'm obsessed with this. Next we have Interlude, the trio. Oh! That's where it is. If I knew how to do math, I could have just added them and gotten the length of the video. Just kidding, we're not listening to that because we just did. Next we are listening to Black Bathing Suit. A crow.
Grenadine, quarantine, I like you a lot. And if this is the end, I want a boyfriend.
Me too!
I'm tired of this shit.
Aren't we all?
The only thing that still fits me is this black bathing suit. You don't know me any better than they do. They said I was bad, let me show you how bad girls do. Cause no one does it better.
This song is different, like every section is very different.
I'm friends with my mother, while I still love my dad. And traditional lover. Can you handle that? Looking at me, looking over at you, real cute.
I love that line.
Cause no one does it better. I said I was bad, let me show you what bad girls do. Cause no one does it better.
I don't know what just happened. I thought I understood this song at the beginning. I was like, okay, she's in quarantine. She wants a boyfriend. She gets a boyfriend. And then I was confused. I really liked this one though, because it was cool. The verse had one distinct sound, the pre-chorus had a distinct sound, then the chorus had a distinct sound. They were all very different, and kind of like the transitions between them were kind of obscure. I wish you could see to my soul through this black bathing suit. Your interest really made stacks, does it say? Lana is referring to the fact that with all the negative interest she's been receiving lately, she doesn't care what you say because the bad things you say make her money. No press is bad. Nope. Bad press. Nope. All press is good. What's the saying? Hold on, I'm gonna go unplug my fridge real quick. If you lie down with me is the next track.
Talk to me with that whiskey breath. Tour me twice, I'll treat you like a holiday.
Okay.
Just do what you do best with me. Dance me all around the room. Spin me like a ballerina super high. If you lie down,
the double use of the word.
La, 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 la,
we both know you la, love it. So lie down next to me.
Gentlemen.
There's something about
pick me up,
there's something about her voice in the verses that's
don't say you're over me when they all know that you ain't.
When they all know
if you lay down and spin me like a ballerina super high.
Oh, I love this.
If you lay down and next to me.
This feels like I'm at a Phoebe Bridgers concert. Whoa! Oh, sorry, we were done. There is something about her voice and the melodies through the verses specifically, but also the chorus. I've just felt that so much. And it was straightforward, which means I got the song, which is so rare with Lana. Sometimes you relate to songs. That's all I'm gonna say. I loved the instrumental outro too. I don't know if that was a trumpet, but it reminded me of like when I went to see Phoebe Bridgers, the trumpet guy, I can't remember his name right now, but he was so good. It just reminded me of that atmosphere. It was, I think like so far, probably Blue Bannisters and If You Lie Down With Me are my favorite ones. Amazing. As always, if you want to check out the uncut version of this album reaction, it is on Patreon. On Patreon, I also have other uncut album reactions, concert reactions. You can get these shout outs. I'm sending you guys postcards. There's a ton of benefits over there if you want to check it out. If not, that's totally okay. Don't worry about it. Thank you so much to everyone who has gone over there already. Without you guys, I wouldn't have a YouTube channel and really wouldn't be doing what I love for a living. So thank you guys so, so, so much. And let's keep going. Next, we're going to a song, straightforward title. Beautiful. Okay. Sure.
Don't tell me to be glad when I'm sad. I really hate that. If I could be more like you, I would, but I can't, and I'm glad about that. What if someone had asked, Castle not to be sad? Never known who he was or the man he become. There would be no period.
Ooh.
Let me show you how sadness can turn into happiness. I can turn blue into something.
Oh no.
Beautiful. Beautiful like you. I try not to hold back. It seems either way it makes you mad. So I'll be who I'll be. If you think that that's cool, then I'll take you back.
Oh.
What if I can turn blue into something beautiful? Beautiful.
I quit. I'm done. Bye. Shut up. So obviously, like, I mean, this just confirmed it for me, but she just like has one of the most beautiful voices I've ever heard. And it just sounds so effortless. It just sounds like she opens her mouth and it just happens. It really hit me when she said, what if someone had asked Picasso not to be sad? Let me show you how sadness can turn into happiness. I can turn blue into something beautiful. Beautiful like you. That writing is everything to me. Also, I can do something blue into something beautiful. Blue banisters, we're kind of going back to that a little bit, because blue in that song, I think, stands for sadness, because she turns the blue banisters to green and gray. I feel like this song is really simple, and it's probably not a favorite of people's, but it's definitely a favorite of mine. The next song we're gonna get into is a song called Violets for Roses.
There's something in the air. The girls are running around in summer dresses with their masks off, and it makes me so happy. Ever since I fell out of love with you, I fell back in love with me. And boy, does it feel sweet, like a summer breeze. The only mistake that a man can make is trying to make a woman change and trade her violets for roses.
Yes!
There's something in the air. I hope it doesn't change, that it's for real. The beginning of something big happening.
I feel like you have to like close your eyes when you listen to Lana to like fully feel the song, because it's like, whoa, that was gorgeous. I kind of got taken out of it a little bit there because I had a technical difficulty and then I had a cough attack. It's a great time. I feel like at the beginning she must be talking about COVID, no? There's something in the air. The girls were running around in summer dresses with their masks off, and it makes me so happy. Like, COVID coming to an end. Kinda. Are we there yet? Not really. The song describes a situation in which Del Rey's lover gets in between her and her dream, something she's not happy with. My favorite lyric in the song, as basic and simple as it is ever since I fell out of love with you, I fell back in love with me. There's 100 million versions of that lyric out there, but it's one that makes me really happy, so I love that. This is actually really interesting. I didn't think of it this way. I mean, makes sense. The symbolism of roses is directly linked to love and passion, but it is the most common and well-known flower. While violets symbolize wisdom, humility, healing, and femininity. These flowers are usually described as blue, something that Lana visualizes as beautiful. We're back to blue again. That looks purple though, not gonna lie. This song was really pretty. I can't wait to put this song on in the background. Like I said, I've been listening to Norman Rockwell the most, but Lana a lot in the past couple weeks, getting ready for this album, and I just like forgot how calming it is to just have her music on in the background. Next, we are listening to a song called Dealer. I don't know why I made that face when I said dealer. Oh, verse one, Miles Kane. It's not just Lana. Whoa.
Please don't try to find me through my.
Like, who is Miles Kane?
Not one shirt off your back.
Whoa. Like, whoa.
All circuits are busy. Goodbye. All circuits are busy. You're high. All circuits are busy.
That song's just vibes. Just vibes. I don't know anything about Miles Kane, but I like his voice. You guys would know better than me, but I've never heard Lana do anything like that before with her voice. That was super unique, and I really, really liked that. That was just a whole vibey like experience. I don't know how to describe that.
You're all like thunder when you come crashing in. Regattas in the wind. Just do it. Just.
Do it, don't wait.
Do what? Do what?
the majority of the song is Just Do It, and I'm still not sure what we're just doing. The man in this context seems to roll in like thunder. He's wild and unpredictable. Here, Lana's predicting him leaving her as well. She's urging him to just do it, which seems to refer to him disappointing her in the end. Okay, that's kind of what I thought when we got to near the end. If hello just means goodbye, then honey better walk away. Just do it. Just walk away. Just leave me now before I'm in too deep and then you hurt me even more. You act like fucking Mr. Brightside when you're with all your friends, but I know what you're like when the party ends. That whole thing. Mm-hmm. Next, we have a song called Wildflower, Wildfire. Heavy piano track. Always here for a heavy piano track.
Here's the deal. Cause I know you wanna talk about it. I've been running on stardust alone for so long. I wouldn't know what hot fire was. Hot fire, hot weather, hot coffee.
Oh, that's so Lana.
With only
did it for me in this song. The pre-chorus and the chorus, the melodies, so good. Also in the pre-chorus, the lyric slightly different in each pre-chorus. I've been running on stardust alone for so long, and then I've been running on star drip IVs for so long. I don't know what that means, but I love it. She did a lot of cool things, like cool, very Lana-like things in this song with her voice too. Hot fire, hot weather, hot coffee, I'm better. Adore it. And the way she did it was so cool. Next, we are going to a song called Nectar of the Gods. Immediate layering.
I get wild and fucking crazy like you never knew. No, is it like the color blue?
The color blue again. That is definitely a theme on this album.
I used to sing about people like you, not just get high.
I like her voice on that part. She does it a few times throughout the song, and I really like when she goes like high like that. I feel like I don't really have much to say about this one. It's not my favorite. It's a fine song, but in comparison to the ones we've heard so far, definitely not my favorite. Next, we're listening to a song called Living Legend, and I actually feel like, I don't remember where I saw this, but I saw something about how this was like an old track that got leaked or something, and then she didn't put it on a past album. Something like that. This was leaked somewhere. I don't know.
Blackbirds will sing in the same key as you play in the shoes that I bought you. What I never said is you're my living legend.
Who is she singing to? That's what I want to know.
You never cared about my name.
Songs make me feel really calm.
Baby, my living legend.
Living Legend was originally written and recorded around 2013 and is an ode to one of Lana's longtime friend and mentor, Jane Powers. Aww. The original recording of the song leaked on July 27, 2020. Oh! The lyrics, I don't know, they were just so intriguing in the way she was so, like, clearly singing for one person in a way that was more identifiable than in her other songs. I don't know why, but it just was like, I was intrigued by the person she was singing to based on the way she was singing about them, if that makes sense. Next, we have a song called Cherry Blossom. I love cherry blossoms.
But you don't tell no one, you can tell me. I push you high, cherry blossom on your sycamore tree.
Wow. Back to Cruel World again. Angelina? Wait, who's Angelina? Okay, that one was pretty simple, but I want to know who Angelina is. This is one of the potential names Del Rey wants for her future daughter. Whoa, okay, whoa, hold on. Either to a future daughter, which makes sense why she said mommy is there, and I was like, huh? But this interpretation, it could also be a synonym for Lana herself, as the song can be interpreted as being sung on the perspective of the mother Lana never had. I don't know if that's the correct interpretation, but ooh. That one, knowing like the context of it, makes it even better. I like it. It's not like up there as one of my favorites, but knowing like what it means and where it comes from, and like the inclusion of like saying Angelina in that last chorus, I really like that. This has brought us to the last song on what is actually a pretty long album, but I feel like that's kind of standard for Lana since her songs are so long individually. But this last song is called Sweet Carolina.
Okay.
Sir?
Don't have to write me a letter.
Ooh.
Cause I'll always be right here. We love every hair on your head. Love you like God.
What is it about her voice on this?
And you say that you're scared, might be unprepared for having the baby blues.
Ooh, okay. Is her voice like extra crisp and clear on this track, or is it just me? And then when she, the pre-chorus, the high parts, whew.
Things ever go wrong, just know this is your song and we love you.
Who, what? Who we love?
Jason is out in the lawn and he power washes every time things go wrong. If you're stressed out, just know you can dance to your song, cause we got you.
Why do I love this one so much? Ones that I don't know what it is about that song, but it's absolutely perfect. Wait, co-written by Lana's father and sister? Oh, that's cool. The song title may refer to Chuck Grant, whose full name is Caroline. Oh, I love this. This is easily one of my favorites. I just think the lyrics are kind of fun. Like the second verse, you name your babe Lilac Heaven after your iPhone 11. Crypto Forever screams your stupid boyfriend. Fuck you, Kevin. So, don't mind my hair. It's probably kind of all over the place. There we have Lana's 8th album. I cannot believe this is her 8th album. It doesn't feel like it, but it is. That is Blue Bannisters. And I adore it. I really, really, really do. And the reason I know like this is a good album for me, like an album that I love, is because I really liked it on first listen. And I feel like with Lana albums, so often like I need a lot of listens to really get to know the album and know whether or not I like it. But this one, I really liked it on first listen. Now there are some tracks I didn't love the first time I've heard them, but because of just like the whole vibe of the album, I think with more listens, those will grow on me. I just adore her voice. I truly think she has one of the most like effortlessly beautiful voices ever. Like I can can definitely see this album being up there with Norman Rockwell for me. I don't think any album she ever makes ever again will beat that album, but I can see this one being up there. Okay, well, in a few days, when I sit down to edit this video and I've listened to the album a few more times, this is my ranking of the album. I do have some clear favorites as of my first listen. That would be, obviously, Blue Bannisters, Arcadia, If You Lie Down With Me, Beautiful, Wildflower, Wildfire, and Sweet Carolina. Those are my favorites as a first listen, but with more, I'm sure it'll shift around a whole bunch because some of these, like, I can't even, like, keep straight in my head right now. I can't say enough good things about this. I think it was a beautiful, beautiful project, and I'm just so happy to finally have been able to listen to it after being sick for 2 weeks, and I still am not better. It's really annoying. I'm just so over it. Anyway, thank you guys so much for being here, for supporting me, for hanging out with me, and listening to Lana with me. Thank you for supporting Lana. She is an incredible artist, and I'm just obsessed with her dang voice and her writing and everything. I can't believe it. I cannot believe it. Okay, I'm done. Freaking out. We're done. Thank you guys so much for being here. Like, subscribe if you want to, but if you don't, that's totally fine. Don't worry about it. It's cool. We can still be friends. This was a fun time just for us to hang out together this one time. That's cool. Thanks for being here, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye, guys.